from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Liquid.
What is a liquid?
A liquid is something that flows.
A liquid is something that takes the shape of anything you put it in.
You can't really hold it in your hands because it just strikes through.
Water is a liquid. Uh-huh. Juice is a liquid.
Yeah.
Lakes. Oceans.
Oceans are liquid?
Yeah.
Keep listening for the word liquid today on Sesame Street.
Liquid.
That's the word on the street.
Bubbly feet.
Never before seen
on Sesame Street.
Well, Elmo loves bubbles.
Yeah, me too.
Me three. Bubbles are excellent.
Oh, then you are in the right bubble fest, my friend.
But first, who here has actually blown a bubble?
Elmo has.
I've blown big bubbles.
Wait. You mean to tell me bubbles aren't magic?
Bubbles are not magic.
Anybody can blow a bubble, but you. Or you. Or even you!
And we're gonna show you how right now.
I'm so excited. I've never blown a bubble before.
Me neither. My mommy always makes them for me.
Watch closely, everyone. The trick to blowing bubbles is to first dip your wand into the bubble mix. The mix, please, Chris.
Mix, Alan.
Then you slowly blow into the center of the wand and...
Bubbles!
Oh, look at that!
All right, bubble blowers, you give it a try.
All right, you guys try.
Try it, Amar.
Give it a try.
Try it.
Yeah. All right, let's see it. Go, Amar.
Okay.
Oh, there it is.
Hey, Bubblicious bubble blowing, Elmo.
Thank you.
Okay, my turn.
Oh, remember, Abby, slow and steady. Go ahead, Chris.
Oh, boy. I bet I'm going to be an awesome bubble blower. Stand back, everybody, and watch the bubbles fly. Thank you. Hey, where's the bubbles?
Well, try again, Tally.
It didn't work.
Sorry, Tally.
I'm not giving up. This is Bubble Fest. I've got to figure out how to blow a bubble for Bubble Fest!
For Bubble Fest!
For Bubble Fest!
Good luck, Kelly!
And now, Bubble Buddies, it's time for a Bubble Mix Mystery.
Ooh. What's a Bubble Mix Mystery?
Ooh. It's the mystery
of how to make
the
perfect bubble mix.
Ooh. How do you make the perfect bubble mix?
Yeah.
Let's solve that mystery!
Bubble solution is a mix made of three ingredients. Water, soap, and something called corn syrup. Now, did any of these ingredients make bubbles by themselves?
No.
But you put them all together and they form a bubble solution.
Ooh, isn't that mysterious?
Elmo thinks so.
Yeah, me too.
Now, in order to make our bubble solution, one ingredient goes into the large cup, one goes into the medium cup, and one goes into the small cup.
But which ingredients go into which measuring cup?
Ah, that's the bubble mix mystery.
Well, Elmo thinks that the soap should be in the large cup because bubbles come from soap.
Okay, soap. Soap into the large cup.
There it goes.
Oh, that's soapy right there.
Very good. There we go.
Okay. And I think that maybe the water should go in the medium cup.
All right, water in the medium.
medium cup.
Okay, there goes our water.
Okay, and the syrup goes into the small cup.
All right, corn syrup in the small cup.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's gloppy.
Yeah, that is a little gloppy.
Here it is. Hey. All right.
All righty. Now, let's
test that mix.
Cool.
Okay, pour.
Oh, boy.
Wow, that's cool.
You good? Awesome.
Yeah.
Check this out.
Ooh. Yeah.
Okay.
Mix it up. Stir.
Okay. Testing one, please. Yeah. Wait, come on.
Well, it worked, but it didn't make that many bubbles.
Yeah. I wonder why it didn't work so well.
Well, maybe it has too much soap in it.
Maybe. Let's try a new mix.
Yeah.
New mix!
Okay, since there was so much soap last time, maybe we should put the soap in the medium cup.
Okay. All right. Soap into the medium cup. Check.
That's good.
Okay.
And corn syrup in the small cup.
Corn syrup in the small cup. Check.
Which means the water is for the large cup.
Water for the large cup. Check, check.
There you go.
And now, let's test that mix!
Okay.
All right.
I got a good feeling about
this
one.
There goes that syrup.
Okay. Now I get my spoon here.
And mix.
Stir. Okay. Testing wand, please.
Thank you.
Okay. Wow! That's cool. Hey, you guys did it!
You solved the bubble mix mystery!
Okay. I am ready!
To play the tuba?
No. To blow bubbles. Oh. Alan, you hold up the wand with the mix, and I will blow at it with the tuba.
Okay, Bubble Fest fans!
Let's see if Telly can blow a bubble with the tuba.
Yeah. Ready? Well, don't worry. I will blow bubbles yet. I have to. This is Bubble Fest!
Bubble Fest!
Bubble Fest!
And speaking of Bubble Fest, it's time for a Bubble Fest riddle!
Oh, yay!
What's round and wet?
Is something you blow.
And has all the colors of the rainbow.
Oh, well, something you blow.
Oh, someone does. Oh, you can blow into a straw, a rainbow-colored straw.
Yeah, but Elmo's straw isn't really round.
Oh, yeah.
Well, how about a balloon?
Huh? Well, a balloon is round, but is it wet?
Oh, no, but...
A beach ball is?
Well, yeah, a beach ball is only wet when you put it in water.
Oh, boy, this is hard. Can we have a hint?
Well, it is Bubble Fest.
Hey, Elmo.
What?
I think the answer has something to do with bubbles.
Bubbles?
Mm-hmm.
But Elmo knows bubbles are clear, Abby.
Yeah, but the hint was Bubble Fest.
Yeah.
And bubbles are round and wet and you blow them.
Yeah, well.
I think the answer has something to do with bubbles.
Well, Elmo doesn't think so, but let's try.
Okay.
Is the answer bubbles?
Oh, ding, 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 ding.
The answer is bubbles.
Oh, yay!
Wait a minute.
Really?
Bubbles have color?
Ah, don't just take our word for it.
Observe the bubbles.
Wow! I see red!
Wow, that's cool! Elmo sees blue!
Oh, and green?
Purple! Wow, bubbles are lots of colors!
That's because bubbles are iridescent.
Huh?
Iridescent! That means you can see all the colors of the rainbow on the bubble!
Really? Yeah. Ooh, iridescent!
Yeah!
Okay, I've got it this time! I'm gonna blow bubbles with this.
What is that, Kelly?
It's a bellows. Here, watch this. Bubble wand, please.
Bubble wand.
Bubble wand.
All right, here I go. maybe it needs to go a little faster, like this. Maybe faster, like this. Faster, even faster. Oh, all right. I am not giving up. I will blow a bubble yet. I have to. For Bubble Fest.
For Bubble Fest!
For Bubble Fest!
And now it's time for a Bubble Fest Pop Quiz!
Hey, I like that, because the bubble pop, that's what the bubble does. No?
Huh? Time for a Pop Bubble Quiz! Come on.
All right, now, which of these items can you blow bubbles with?
Well, let's see. That's a bubble wand right here.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And that's made out of pipe cleaners.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And, so is that one. Mm-hmm. So that is two things you can blow bubbles with.
Oh, and this one has a handle. So Emma thinks it's a wand, too. Mm-hmm. So that's one, two, three things that you can blow bubbles with. Yeah. The answer is three.
Sorry. There are more than three things you can blow bubbles with.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, which one?
How about this orange juice can, huh?
Chris blew a bubble with an orange juice can. That's four things to blow bubbles with.
Ah, and check out this cookie cutter. Huh? Oh, hey.
Well, that's five things.
Oh, don't forget this funnel.
Wow, that was a good one.
Six things! Yeah!
Well, you can blow bubbles with all of those things.
That's correct, because lots of things can be used to make bubbles.
And bubble wands come in all different sizes. Mm.
That can be used to make big bubbles.
Wow, cool!
And bigger bubbles.
Really, really cool!
And the biggest bubbles.
Dum-dum-dum, the Bubble Fest finale!
Well, what's the dum-dum-dum, the Bubble Fest finale?
We are gonna make a bubble so big,
so huge,
so enormous,
that you could fit a human child inside.
How about what?
You're gonna need a magic wand for that.
Oh, no magic.
Just a volunteer.
Me.
Great, Crystal. Hey, walk this way.
Okay, Crystal. Now take off your shoes. Uh-huh.
That's right. Okay, and now we're gonna step into the center of the pool. Uh-huh. I'll hold this. Got it. There we go. I'll help you. There we go.
Cool.
Okay, guys. We're gonna do this on the count of three. Ready?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Okay, everybody, this is gonna work. I'm gonna blow bubbles. Watch this, and here we go.
Is Kelly all right?
I'm all right. I just can't do it. I can't blow bubbles.
Whoa, did you see that?
Do it again, Telly, do it again.
I'm doing it! I'm blowing bubbles!
And with that, it's time to bring Bubble Fest to an end!
With a bubbling Bubble Fest salute!
Everybody make bubbles!
I'm George.
And I'm Abby.
Elmo's Elmo.
And we are here today to tell you about the word liquid.
Liquid!
You guys ready?
Yeah, ready.
Great. Now go get some liquids.
Oh, okay. first, Abby. Okay.
Now, a liquid is something that flows and takes the shape of any container that it's in.
Okay. I got a liquid, George.
Good. You see this? It's a bottle of orange juice. And orange juice is a liquid. See, the liquid takes the shape of the bottle. Now, watch this.
Okay.
The juice is flowing, and now it's taking the shape of the glass. Orange juice is...
a liquid.
Thanks, Abby.
You're welcome, George. Oh, Elmo has a liquid for Mr. George, too. Here we go.
Awesome. See this? It's milk. It is taking the shape of the pitcher. Now, watch. The milk is flowing, and now it is taking the shape of the bowl. The milk is...
A liquid.
Thanks, Elmo.
You're welcome. Oh, boy. Oh, you know what? I got another liquid, George.
Check it out. There's seltzer in here, and it is taking the shape of the bottle. And now...
What's wrong?
Oh, I don't know. The seltzer isn't flowing.
Oh, no problem. I got this.
The bottle's clogged.
Seltzer flow!
Liquid!
It's almost time for Abby's flying fairy school. But right now, I'm trying to catch a bubble, but they keep popping! Why can't I catch a bubble without it popping?
Vamos a averiguarlo!
Great idea, Ovejita! Let's find out! Yeah, yeah! Want to know what it's all about? Ask a question and let's find out! Hey, guys! How do you catch a bubble?
Let's find out!
Yeah! See if you can catch one without making it pop.
I caught that one. I'll go tiny one.
Why do you think they pop? They do pop really easily. A lot of bubbles pop. We kept a few, right?
But a few.
So yeah. Bubbles are made out of soap. And why do you think they're popping?
Because it's really thin layer of just stuff, and there's air inside it, and there's air outside. Yeah.
I think we could set up an experiment to see if there are some surfaces that bubbles will land on better than on other surfaces.
Oh, boy! We're going to do an experiment to see if we can catch some bubbles. But right now, check this out.
Letter B is taking us to a world that starts with a sound.
Letter B day. So show me what you brought that starts with the letter B.
Banana!
Oop, oop, oop. Belly button baloney!
Bunny!
Oh.
beautiful B words. Brava.
That bunny just bopped Mrs. Sparkle Nose on the head.
At least bop is a B word. Let me check my big book of bopping beasts.
That's no ordinary bunny. That's
Little Bunny Foo-Foo. Huh? Oh, you've never heard of the infamous Bunny Foo-Foo? His story goes like this. Little Bunny Foo-Foo, hopping through the forest, scooping up the field mice and bopping them on the head. Down came the good fairy, and she said,
Little Bunny Foo-Foo, I don't want to see you scooping up the field mice and bopping them on the head. I'll give you 3 more chances, otherwise I'll turn you into a goon.
And what happened?
He kept bopping and bopping until finally the good fairy came and turned Bunny Foo-Foo into a goon.
Why isn't he a goon anymore?
Goon spells don't last forever. You have to do them a goon and a goon. I mean again and again.
Come on! Let's stop this bunny's bopping and turn him into a goon!
I don't know if we should.
Keep your wings calm, Donegan.
I'm trying!
Where's Donegan?
He's gone again!
Well, we can't wait. We have to turn this bunny into a goon. We need your help. Use your wand or your finger. Point it at Bunny Foo-Foo and say, you're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon!
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon!
Oh, no! What happened to Gonagan?
He's goon again!
Huh? I'm a goon?
Looks like we gooned the wrong guy.
Don't worry. I just need to degoonify him. Goon, be gone.
That Foo-Foo sure is fast.
We can't get the spell out in time.
Maybe we just need to put something on our head that will keep Foo-Foo there long enough to do the spell.
Great thinking, Gonagan. But remember, today is B Day, so it has to be something that starts with the letter B.
Let's twinkle think. What's something that starts with B that'll keep a bunny on your head?
Twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle think.
A beret?
Nah,
won't hold him. A book?
Nah, we don't even know if he can read.
I know! Bubblegum!
No! Don't you know you're never supposed to put bubblegum in your hair?
Yeah, you're overthinking it. It starts with a B, and it's sticky. Ow! Here, Foo-Foo! I got a nice head for you to bop! It worked! Hurry! Do the spell!
Wands up, everyone!
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon! Goon!
Oh, no! Am I a goon?
Hard to tell.
Okay. Goon be gone!
Ah, there's that handsome face I know and love.
Okay, so the bubble gum didn't hold Foo-Foo long enough, and it messed up your hair. We better think some more.
What can keep a bunny on your head long enough to do the spell?
Let's twinkle think.
Twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle think.
Oh, when you eat, you stay in one place. So what kind of food does a bunny eat?
Carrots.
Then maybe we could put a carrot on our heads. And then Fufu will stop and eat the carrot and give us enough time to do the spell.
Great idea. Here you go, Bunny Fufu. Hurry, do the spell.
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon!
I'm a goon. Goon, be gone.
Oh, how come the carrot didn't work? Bunnies love carrots.
Because Bunny Fufu knows it's a bee day. You need some vegetables that begin with B.
We better think of vegetables that begin with B.
Twinkle, twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle think.
Beets!
Oh, and beans!
And booger berries!
Maybe not booger berries.
Okay! How about broccoli?
Oh, yum, yum.
Beautiful! Bee vegetables coming up! Snack time, Bunny Fufu!
Oh, yum, yum.
He's eating!
All right, fairies! You know what to do!
You're a goon! You're a goon! You're a goon!
Oh, it worked! Yay!
We turned him into a goon!
Aw, poor guy. If he can't bop, what's he gonna do now?
I always wanted to do ballet.
Great B word, Fufu. Come on, class. Let's boogie.
It's almost time for Super Grover 2.0. But right now, we're going to do an experiment to see if we can catch some bubbles. In order to catch a bubble, you can choose from the soapy water, the gloves, the dirt, the aluminum foil, and the clay water. Bronwyn, what are you going to choose to catch a bubble?
I think I'll have to go with the dirt.
Go for it, Bronwyn! Yeah, those are some nice dirty hands. Good luck!
What did you choose?
I chose dirt.
What do you think's going to happen?
I think it'll stay for a few seconds, but not for a long time.
Okay, let's give it a try.
No.
Don't work.
The dirt didn't work. George, what are you gonna choose?
I'm gonna choose the tin foil.
Oh, go for it, George! Good luck! George caught it with the tin foil! Yes! Sam, what are you gonna choose?
I think I'll choose soapy water.
Go for it, Sam! Good luck, Sam! The soapy water worked! We're gonna keep experimenting in a few minutes, but right now, check this out.
Let's blow bubbles. That didn't work. I'll try to blow a little harder. Oops, that was too hard. Let me try again. Oh, it worked. It's a bubble. One bubble. Two bubbles. Three bubbles. Four bubbles. One, two, three, four bubbles.
Eliana and William, what's up next?
Super Grover 2.0.
Oh, yeah!
He observes.
Oh, look! No! Oh, no! Ah!
He 20 questions.
Hubba what?
He investigates.
What does this button do?
Super Grover 2.0. He shows up. Somewhere along the Pretty Good Wall of China, a chicken is attempting to do the unthinkable.
Oh my gosh. I just gotta get over this wall. I just gotta. Super Grover, is that you?
No! It is I, Super Grover 2.0! I am even superer than ever, and cuter too. What seems to be the problem, my little fricassee?
Oh, well, it's this wall. I just gotta climb over, but it's too high.
But why do you want to go over the wall?
To get to the other side. It's a chicken thing.
So, the question is, how does a chicken get over the wall?
That's it in an eggshell.
Do not despair, my fair feathered fowl, for I will unleash the power of observation to help you get over the wall. Mm-hmm. Aha!
What aha?
I observe with my super eyes that you have flappy flappers.
Well, you mean my wings?
Yes, you can just flap those chicken wings and fly over the wall.
But Super Grover 2.0, chickens can't fly.
I will figure out another way to get you up and over the wall. I will now unleash the power of investigation. Excuse me, Wall. Could you just scooch down a tad so that the chicken can get over you? Excuse me, Wall. Wall? It's like talking to a brick wall.
It is a brick wall.
Listen, Wall, you'd be doing me a huge favor if you did this.
I wonder if I could just jump over it.
No, just an inch. Yeah. That's all I need. No, just, you know, a sipping.
Oh, this wall is just too high. I'll never get over it.
It is time to unleash the power of technology. I will just look into my utility sock. There must be a tool in here somewhere. Aha! Springs! My super senses are telling me these springs are very springy. Come here, chicken.
What? Come.
There. These should put a spring in your step. Now you can jump over the wall.
Oh, I don't know, Super Grover 2.0. These springs are pretty wobbly.
Jump, chicken, jump!
All right.
Might I say that you're no spring chicken?
These springs don't work. I still can't jump high enough, and I just gotta get over that wall. I just gotta!
Now calm your giblets. I am Super Grover 2.0. I am all about the technology. Now, let me see what other highly advanced tools I have in my sock. Aha! A hole poker, mabob.
That's a pole.
Step aside, chicken. I, Super Grover 2.0, will poke a hole in this wall with this hole poker, mabob.
But this ball, it's made out of brick. It's just too hard.
Yes, but even the Pretty Good Wall of China is no match for my pretty good muscles. I believe I've hit the wall.
Told you so.
I just need to try this again. Yeah.
Yeah, but Super Grover, Super Grover. Did you see that?
I see stars.
No, that pole. Look, it works like a lever.
A what?
A lever. A lever is a tool that helps you move heavy things. Look, it pivots on the ground. Watch this. Ready? Pivot.
Pivot, pivot.
This is a pivotal moment. My super senses are telling me that this whole poker-mabob is in fact a lever-mabob.
Yep, we just need a taller pole.
Wow, that is a mighty tall lever-mabob.
It is even taller than this lever-mabob.
Well, it's got to be tall to get over the wall.
And so, our superhero discovered that levers are tools that can help chickens go over walls.
And me, too! I think I need a longer lever. Or a shorter wall.
It's almost time for Elmo, but right now, we're gonna continue with our experiment! Gus, what are you gonna choose?
The gloves.
Okay, take the gloves and try to catch those bubbles. Aw, the gloves didn't work. All right, Ava and Hannah, one choice left. You get the water. Go for it. All right, guys, go catch those bubbles.
It worked!
Wow! So some materials make the bubble pop! And some don't! Ooh, ooh, ooh. I did it! I caught a bubble! Overheat! Keep watching, because Elmo's popping in soon!
When there's a problem to be solved, but you don't know where to begin. When you could use some sort of hero, he comes dropping in. Super Grover 2.0, always on the job wherever he goes. He tries to help, doesn't always, it's true, but he always shows up.
It's just what they do.
Observation.
Yeah, your powers of observation. Use your senses to get information. What do you see, hear, taste, feel, smell? With observation, what can you tell?
The power of investigation!
Then use your power of investigation. That's another way to get information. Experiment and try things out. See what works, see what it's all about.
I knew that!
Technology that's using tools that can help you see, like a pulley to lift things to a high tower, or wheels to move tools give you the power.
Wheels!
Hey, Jason, thanks for singing this song. With a hero like me, you can't go wrong. I have the power, I have the might to save the day! Who turned out the light?
Yo, get the light!
Tell him what's coming up next!
Elmo!
Yeah!
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world! La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world! Elmo loves his goldfish, his crayon too!
Yeah!
Dorothy. They live in the water. Yeah, like this. Oh, yeah, did you guess yet? Yeah, fishes, yay! You know, fishes. They live in water. Oh. And they tickle, too. Is, how do you pretend to be a fish? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Oh, wow. Oh, that really looks like water shade. Thank you. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Over here, Mr. Noodle. No, here, Mr. Noodle. Oh, boy. Your hat is over your eyes, Mr. Noodle. Your hat, yeah. Oh, look! It's Mr. Noodle's brother, Mr. Noodle! Hi, Mr. Noodle! Hi! Oh, Dorothy asks, how do you pretend to be a fish, Mr. Noodle? Yeah, you, Mr. Noodle. You.
That's not a fish.
He's pretending to be a dog.
No, no! Fish can't scratch their ears!
He's rolling around like a dog.
I think he's scratching his back.
Swim, Mr. Noodle.
Fish don't beg.
Fishes swim.
Fish don't eat bones.
Bones are for dogs, not fish.
Let's see your fish, Mr. Noodle.
Fishes have fins, so they can swim.
You need to swim to be a fish.
You're doing it wrong.
Not like that.
You're not being a fish.
That's a chicken, Mr. Noodle. He's being a chicken.
Chickens can't swim.
Not even the breaststroke.
Fish don't cluck.
Their mouths say,
glub, 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 glub.
Be a fish, Mr. Noodle.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle, you're doing it. That's a fish.
Almost as good as Dorothy.
He looks like a real fish. All he needs is some water.
Mr. Noodle! Thank you, Shade. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you pretend you're a fish?
Hi, Dorothy. This is the way I pretend to be a fish. I move my mouth. I wiggle my tail. And I move my fins. And I swim around.
Hi, Dorothy. This is how I pretend to be a goldfish.
Dorothy says you remind her of her Uncle Fred. Oh, Dorothy. Thank you. Thank you, kids. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Bloop, 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 bloop. Oh, hi, baby. Hello. Baby, how do you pretend to be a fish? Thank you, baby. Mwah. Bloop, 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 bloop. Oh, Elmo's pretending to be a fish. How's that, Dorothy? Thank you. Now, Elmo has a question. Bloop, 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 for you. Yeah, you. How many fishes do you see? Let's count them. Ah, there's one fish. She's very pretty.
One.
Two.
Three.
Oh, four. One fish. Yay!
Three.
Two. One fish. Wow. And one shell. Nice fishy. Nice fishy.
Thank you.
Oh, great counting, everybody. But Elmo wonders, where in the world can fishes live? Let's see. Oh, drawer. Can fishes live in a drawer? Oh. Can fishes live in a bus? In a birthday cake? Or a river?
In a river.
Fishes live in water.
Very good, that's right. Can fishes live in a stroller? In a car? Or in a lake?
A lake.
It's water.
That's right. Now, where does Dorothy live? Does she live in an ocean, in a raindrop, or in a fishbowl?
In a fishbowl.
Yes, with Elmo. Oh, and Elmo loves Dorothy. Mwah! Thanks, Drew.
Elmo has mail.
Mouse. Thank you.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, no! Elmo's got email from his friend Tilly.
Hi, Elmo. I got a new fish for my fish tank. And it looks just like me. How about that? See ya, Elmo.
Oh, thank you, computer. Thank you. Drawer! Oh, there you are! Oh, Elmo's friend Brandon went with his daddy to look at fishies at the aquarium. And he told Elmo all about it.
The aquarium is a zoo of animals that live in the water, especially fishes. The biggest fish I saw was a shark. Wow! There were lots of sharks, and another big fish called a grouper. Next, we saw seahorses. Seahorses look like little horses' heads, and they're fish too. I saw fishes of every color from Africa and South America. Clownfish, lionfish, piranhas, all kinds of fish. Some fishes look alike and always swim together. That's called a school of fish. And then we saw some rays. We got to touch them. They felt soft. And I got to feed them. I wasn't scared. A sea lion isn't a fish, but it lives in the sea. Boy, can they swim. An octopus isn't a fish either, but it lives in the sea too. We saw fishes from all over the world, and they were awesome.
Wow. Fishes are all over the world. Did you know that, Dorothy? Huh? Oh, yeah. Dorothy said, of course. Boy, all those fishies. Where can Elmo learn more about them? Yeah, Elmo can watch the Fish Channel. Thank you for coming, television. Turn yourself on.
It's the Fish Channel. All fishes, all newts, all the time. And now, Finn fans, here's Bubbles Martin in the swim with How Do Fishes Move?
Bubbles Martin underwater asking, how do fishes move?
A few of them look like they're flying. Hi, Ray! Most fishes move by wiggling their body, tail, and fins. The works! Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. You want to get anywhere as a fish, you gotta wiggle!
Here's a thing that fishes know when they got some place to go. Just to swim there fast or slow, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. They got tails, they got fins, they got scales on their skins. But when travel time begins, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. Godfish with their puppies know, and guppies who are on the go, to start swimming, hey, diddle, diddle, clip your tail and bend in the middle. There's a thing that fishes know when they got some place to go. Just to swim there fast or slow, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. See you at Laguna Beach, and that's how fishes move.
Stay tuned for Name That Tuna. 60 minnows and touched by an angel fish.
Thank you, Tootie. Alma would like to know more about fishies, wouldn't you? How can we find out more? Oh, here we go again, yay! Bloop, bloop, bloop.
Why don't you talk to a fish?
Who said that?
I hope you don't mind. And I brought my own water. Fish live in the water, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Even a kingfish.
Oh, he's a kingfish. Wow.
Yes, wow. Every inch a kingfish. Mm. This is my royal tail. I use it to swim.
His royal tail.
And my royal fins. I use them to swim, too.
His royal fins.
And my royal gills. I use them to breathe.
His royal... what was that again?
My royal gills.
His royal gills.
Yes, and my royal mouth. I use it to say forsooth.
His royal forsooth. What else can fish do besides swim and breathe and speak forsooth?
Well, anything almost. They can blow up like a balloon if they're puffers. What is that goldfish doing?
Oh, don't just imagine it. Alma is a puffer.
Some fish can fly, if they're flying fish.
Ready for takeoff!
And some fishes can make their own light, if they're angler fish.
Elmo's an angler fish. That's a switch. Now Elmo fish can read his book of fish stories.
Goldfish, dreamers all.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, Mr. Kingfish. Hey, don't go away. Dorothy wants to sing the fish's song.
Oh.
This one's for you, Dorothy. Here we go. Fishes, 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 fishes. Come on, sing.
Fishes, 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 fishes. Fishes, 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 fishes. Fishes, 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 fishes.
by Bubbles! This is Murray saying see you next time on the street. Peace!
PBSKids.org to visit your Sesame Street friends for videos, games, and sunny days.